Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today I'm going to walk you through a new app I've started using called Lottie. It is a way to make animations that are pretty simple to more complex, but what I like about it is it's very intuitive to use, and I was able to get up and running making some really nice, subtle animations for some presentations I was working on in minutes. It was really, really fantastic. So today I'm going to walk you through a scenario where I need to give a presentation. I have a slide where I want to put an animated icon, just something really simple, but something that'll spice up the slide a little bit. And I'm going to show you how I do it from start to finish. It's only going to take a few minutes, and maybe this will be useful for you for other things. You can use this for UI design. You can use it for, again, presentations, video stuff, a lot of applications, but wanted to show it to you today so you have an idea for what's out there. Okay, so we're just going to do this like an old school, a better computer video. I'm just going to show you a quick project in real time. Hopefully, it'll give you an idea for how to use the tool. So basically, I have this slide deck here. This is based on a real thing I did recently where I want to add an icon up here, and I want it to animate so that for the few seconds it's on screen, there's something kind of interesting to look at. So I know Font Awesome has this sliders icon that is pretty cool, and I could just make these little cog things move left and right in the animation. Perfect. Awesome. Let's go ahead and recreate it in Lottielab. So we're going to create a new file. And for what it's worth, you can also import from Figma. There's a Figma import extension that works really, really nice. Basically brings in all your layers and then you can animate them. So if you want to design in Figma and then import it in here, that works really great from what I've experienced. But let's just make it all here so you can see the tools. So the first thing I want to do is I want to use the shape tool to create a circle. So we'll make a circle that takes up most of the space. And let's go ahead, let's take a look at the color scheme. So I don't really want that. Let's take a screenshot of this and then drag that in to the dock just so I can grab these colors. So let's set this color to, let's set the background to this kind of dark color here. Cool. And now let's go ahead and go about adding those lines. So I'm gonna create a rectangle. Just a very narrow one. We'll do something like this. There we go. Center it reasonably well. I'm going to increase the corner radius to like 100 just to max it out. There we go. Cool. And now we want to change the color of this one to, how about this gray? No, you can't see it. How about, actually, let's do a lighter gray. So let's make it like this. I could really obsess about the colors, but I want to show you just how it works in general. So there's that. We want this to be 122 apart from each. So 123, 122. So one more. So now that these should be evenly spaced, 123 pixels between both of them. Cool. And I'm doing that by holding the option button down on my keyboard, which is pretty common for design apps. So I've got my lines, but if we go back here, we also need to add the circles with the kind of transparent middles. So I'm going to go to the circle tool, the ellipse tool. I'm going to hold shift to make a perfect circle. We'll make it kind of that size, center it on this guy. And then to do this, let's make the stroke the kind of light gray that I have. Let's make the width of it more like that. And then this background, we want it to look like it's that brown. So let's go to the fill and hit the brown. And there you go. So now we have, it's probably a little big. I could probably shrink this down. So let's go ahead and shrink it down a bit. There we go. That's well sized. So now I'm just going to hold down option and drag a copy over here, drag a copy over here. And at this point we've generally created, there it is. Here's the Font Awesome one. Again, I could obsess over it a little bit more, but looks pretty good. Now it's time to animate. So we're going to select the artboard, and you're going to see if we go into animate, it's going to open up this timeline down here, and it's a 3-second timeline. It's going to default to 3 seconds. You can change it to pretty much anything. I've gone up to 60 seconds. That works fine. Just be mindful, it's going to be a larger file when you export the GIF or the video or whatever you're doing. And so basically, to start doing something down here, you need to select an object. So I'm going to select this circle, and I want to basically have it move to the right, move to the left, and kind of loop, right? So I need to end at the same place it starts. And so my trick for that is just go to the very end of your timeline, hit the plus icon with that item selected, and that's going to make sure that no matter what you do in the middle with moving it around, it'll end up exactly where it started. So for this one, let's just go to the middle, hit plus, and we're going to now drag the file over. We'll drag it over to this far. And you can already see it animating. So let's go down here and hit spacebar to play. It's moving back and forth. And that's okay, but it's could be better. But let's do the other ones real quick and do that exact same thing. So go to the end, add a keyframe to make sure this one starts there. We'll offset this a little, but we'll add a plus there. Don't need that. Gonna slide this over maybe a little less far. And then let's select our third and final cog thing. Go to the end. We'll move this one maybe here is where we'll do this new keyframe. We'll slide it over, and this one will slide maybe more than the others. So what do we have? Let's deselect all of our layers, just play the animation. And at this point, it's honestly not horrible. it's a little static though, so let's spice up these animations. So this one right here, I think we'll spice up first. So I'm gonna pause it. I'm going to select this guy. And when I'm hovering over the track for this one, you're gonna see linear here. And that's the basically the ease in, out, kind of how is the animation playing out. So basically linear is gonna be, it's always at a constant speed, it never changes. And that can work fine, but it looks a little just boring here. So if I right click this, I can go to easing, and there's a whole bunch of options. And for this one, I'm gonna try bounce in. I think this one's gonna have it bounce at the end. So let's play. It kind of bounces and then comes back. Cool. I like that actually quite a bit. So bounce in is good, but then it linearly goes back. So for going back, I think what I could do is slow down maybe. So I think it'll kind of go over here, it'll bounce, and then on its way back, it will kind of gradually slow down. So let's go ahead and play the animation. So it bounces and scoots back. It's a little jagged. It kind of has like this little pop of animation when it goes into the slowdown. Let's see if we can fix that. Is there a way? What if we do bounce in? How does this one work? Oh, this is probably gonna be very weird. Yeah, that's worse. Don't do that. Maybe bounce out again. Just bounce out for both. No, bounce in, bounce out. Maybe that's what I want. There we go. Oh no, that's terrible. I think what we're gonna wanna do, maybe natural, could natural work? No, because that's gonna, no, that's weird. So I think I'm going to do slow down. It wasn't perfect, but it's pretty darn close. And I think on a slide that's playing on a screen that's very large and away from you, you're probably not going to notice it. So, okay, I think that first one's pretty good. Let's move on to this guy. And honestly, let's just do the same thing. We're going to do bounce out. Cool. That's actually pretty good. I like that quite a bit. So we'll stick with that one. This one, I bet you can see what I'm going to do here. I'm going to do, let's do bounce in on this one. What does that do? Let's do bounce in and then slow down maybe. So let's see this one. Oh, that's pretty good. Okay, so now if I just watch this, I could obsess over this again and start tweaking it to be really perfect, but like, that'll work for something that's going to be on screen for like 5 to 10 seconds at most. That's pretty good. So I'm just going to call it there, and I'm going to export this. So exporting, you have a few options. You can embed it as a Lottie file. You can export as a GIF, as a video, or as a Telegram sticker. I'm just going to do it as a GIF. I think a GIF will be nice for this context because it'll just play. So I can choose the frame rate that it's gonna play at. I can change the background. So I do have a circle with a background that I wanna be transparent. So we'll make that transparent. It's gonna re-render. I can choose the resolution. I think it defaults to 480p. So that's gonna be this resolution here. That works fine for me. So let's go ahead and download this. Let's save it. Yeah, that's fine. Cool. And then what we're gonna do is, now that I have the file over here, I'm just going to drag it in here. It's going to go centered. We're going to make it smaller and something like this. Again, I could obsess over the slide design some more, but I have an animated little icon that just took me, it would have taken me less time to make it if I wasn't explaining it the whole way, but like you're able to go from zero to a nice little animation very quickly. I know on their, if we go to just their homepage, they show off some really advanced animations like here, like you can do this as well. And if I spend more time, I could pull it off. But yeah, to do very simple stuff, it's very quick. I will hit pricing real quick. It is expensive. It's free. And if you do an export, it's going to watermark it. So not really great, especially for professional use. But if you need to use it just for a little bit, $18, depending on the context, depending on the stakes of what you're doing and how important it is, that might be worth it to you. So I don't think this is a thing I'll subscribe to all the time, but I will use it on those occasions where I need to create something animated and want to just make it quickly. This is really, really nice. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.